Kuru HS is a partnered Twitch streamer and speedrunner of several car games, most notably the Need for Speed series. At the time of recording this, he currently holds the world record on all 7 categories for Most Wanted 2005 for the full game leaderboard on speedrun.com, as well as serving as one of its moderators. There's a multitude of reasons why Kuru has the top times, and though some of the reasons include experience, driving skill, and driving a Volkswagen Golf throughout the entire game, one of the small but effective reasons includes a simple tuning setup to make the car stronger through the corners. With a steering setup of +5 to improve the cornering ability, and an aerodynamic setup of +5 for faster cornering speeds, on paper you would expect it to help produce faster lap times around all of the game's tracks. Of course, a spoiler is required to adjust the aerodynamic slider. The question is, though, how much better is this setup compared to a vanilla setup? To find out, we finally make a long-awaited return to the old Petersburg test track, testing all the game's stock cars as well as the endgame M3 GTR and Corvette C6R to see just how much they gained from their original time set back in 2016. To find out more about those original times, check out the link in the description to view the times the cars accomplished with full tunes, including Junkman parts. With that out of the way, let's take a look at the laps.
Thank you.
As you just saw, every single car was able to improve their original lap time from 2016, some by a rather notable margin, some not so much. I've included a plus-minus system for each car to show where they now sit on the board compared to their original position 3 years ago. Some surprises here, such as the RX-8 suddenly falling all the way to the bottom. Other cars like the Supra, CTS, Viper, and Mustang also taking notable falls, whilst the SL500 managed to jump up 3 positions. Also rather shocking to see the Murcielago now fall just outside the top 20, whilst both the 911 Turbo S and Subaru Impreza managed to jump up 5 positions, the largest change in position from 3 years ago. We also see the Cobalt and Cayman having practically swapped positions, whilst Carew's Choice in the Golf managed to just climb up 3 spots to enter the top 5. Perhaps unsurprisingly, however, is the top 3. Whilst the Elise and Carrera GT swap spots, the M3 GTR still sits quite notably ahead in first place. Perhaps that was the reason they didn't let you put Junkman parts on it. Maybe Black Box knew it would have had a notable advantage over the other cars. Needless to say though, Carew's tune is well worth applying to all of your vehicles if you want to go even faster. On a small track like this, the change may only knock off a second or two, but on longer tracks, you can expect the difference to be even more substantial. Regardless, it's a change you'll want to make, for the better. It's been a long time coming returning to this track, but stay tuned, as this ain't just going to be a one-off reunion. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button, and hit the subscribe button if you want to see some of my other videos. Make sure to hit the bell icon so you can get notified on what videos I release next. You can also check out my other links down below in the description, where I've got a Patreon if you want to support the channel, a Twitter if you want to come see my ramblings, a Twitch if you want to watch me stream, a Discord if you want to come and chat with me and others about the channel or similar stuff, and a Curious Cat if you want to ask any questions. Huge shout out to Toxic Honey Badger for being an awesome pledger on Patreon. Thanks again, and I will see you guys on the next video.